Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. You have been listening to various speakers, various strategies, various things for the past 1.5 days. I just wanted to give you a little different perspective of what exactly we are doing in this place and how we can exactly take it over to the next level. So today my main focus would be on the Heikin Ashi charting thing. But even before we come to that particular part, we have a few other things which needs to be clarified as a practicing technical analyst or a chartist. I've written one small philosophical quote. All human actions are categorized into two, intentional and unintentional. Whatever we do, always are thought well before we do. That becomes our intentional actions, and many things we do unknowingly, that becomes unintentional actions. But I would say that a powerful mind, a conscious mind, always delivers a thoughtful and deliberate actions, okay? Why I am saying this is very simple, that you need to be in a position to understand that we are all in markets. And how alert your market mind is, depending on the alertness that we have set in on the market screen, that kind of returns you will make. If your mindset is not alert, unfortunately, if you have a wavering mind, you can easily fall into a trap called trading and investing into the market, right? Just a small disclaimer. As a SEBI-registered investment advisor, we are supposed to give this disclaimer that whatever we are discussing out here is for the purpose of education, because out here we are not doing any professional consulting, right? We'll start. How many of you know this person, father of technical analysis? We are here, assembled here to learn something of the technical analysis, but we do not know the origin or how this all started. Okay, he is Mr. Munaisa Homa, a rice trader of the 18th century from Japan. All credit of technical analysis goes to him because he has created something revolutionary, and it is because of his thought that we are all assembled to gather and learn something from technical analysis on this particular day. He was a rice merchant. He was a rice trader from Sakata, Japan. It's a place called Sakata in Japan. What he did is, he started noting down the price movements on a daily basis of the rice, because rice was a staple food of Japan at that point of time. I don't know what they eat right now. But it was a staple food, and when he was trading with rice, the physical form, he wanted to make sure what exactly is happening with the price. So he jotted down the price movements of what is happening, and over a period of time, what he did is, he had an agent kept at every 3 kilometers apart across Japan to understand what are the price movement of that particular rice across Japan on any given point of time, okay? Now, that was the kind of network that he has created during the year of 1780s, 1790s. What he did, he gathered all these price information and just plotted down two important factors, which was the high point of that the particular day and the low point of the day. And he surprisingly started finding out there has been a pattern over a period of time. And that period of, over a period of time, the price pattern is called, he started calling it as yang and yin. That is the laying foundation of the Japanese candlesticks that we are following. I'm sure that if you are a technical analyst, you must be well aware of what a candlestick looks like, but unfortunately, hardly one or two people have that patience to go back into the history and to find out who exactly has created it. Okay? I just wanted to continue with this particular story. The reason is, just even in the last presentation, I was listening in the last part of it, someone from this particular side has asked, will this work? Correct? That was a beautiful question. Even when we discuss many other strategies, many strategies across different platforms, we also have that question in our mind as a technical analyst or an expert. Will this work every time? The answer is clearly no. No analysis will ever work, keep working again and again over a period of time. You need to understand that if you have a problem with neurology, there is no point to go to a heart specialist, right? So you have different specialists, and that is a basic creation of technical analysis. That is what we want to understand or clear it out first in the first place, even before we take it to the very advanced stages. So what he has done is, because of his brilliance of understanding and plotting, see, basically what happens, when you are a creator of something, you always have the first moving advantage, right? So if you go back to the history, we can understand that he is the only person who would have made billions of money from the market right from day one. So if you were to go, be any kind of expertise that we go and learn about that particular person, we always see that they have had very bad experience first, only then they started learning and they get into the profit stream of technical analysis or the market making money, right? But if you were to go to this particular gentleman's history, you will find that Homa is one of the persons who has started making money right from day one, being a creator of the technical analysis, right? Because of his brilliance, what happened is he was inducted into the Japanese government as an advisor. And he is one of the foremost member to be honored by the Japanese government with the title of Samurai. It's like the British government giving you a title of Sir, right? So it is something very honorary that you can afford to get from the Japanese government because of your brilliance. And he was one of the prime members, who means a very, very old person who has received this title, Samurai. He has written many books. Unfortunately, we are left only with two books because over a period of time, what happens since he has written it on the rice plates and all those stuff, many of them got destroyed. And whatever he has founded, whatever he has observed, many things has been lost. In 1755, on one of his famous books that he has written, San and Kinsen Hiroku, The Foundation of Gold, he has mentioned that psychological aspect of market is critical to the trading success, that traders' emotions have a significant influence of rice, on rice patterns. This is what I said. Understanding technical analysis is all about understanding the psychology or the mind aspect of all the participants put together on a given particular day into the market. A very conscious mind always take a deliberate action, and all the deliberated action will definitely have a calculated profile on it, right? So this is one of the basic thing that he has understood, that more than anything else on the patterns and all those stuff, he understood that psychology is what that works behind these markets. And he wanted to understand how this psychology works over a long period of time. And that created the history of creating the yin and yang, or which basically we call it as the bull and the bear market. Price charting. Munessa Homa described the rotation of yang and yin and claims that within each type of market is an instance of the other type. He appears to have used weather, market volume, as well as price in adopting trading positions. He was one of the person that he understood that it is not the weather that influence the supply and demand of the rice. It is not alone the volumes, because we always see that if FIIs come and buy, it will definitely go up, it will definitely go down. And if you were to look at evening data, when the official data is released, you will find to your surprise that FIA would have actually sold, DIs would have bought. So there's always a misconception that if someone buys and someone sells in bulk, it will definitely go up and down. It is not a reflection of that particular thing alone. You need to understand that. So there's a combination, there is a difference combination of different aspects that gets into the market stream. And the adoption of this price, understanding the price, is what has created the basis of technical analysis and the price charting aspect. I don't know how many of you have been trader for the past 20, 30 years, but then if you were to listen 20 years or 30 years back, the traders who were on the Dalal Street, there is a common phrase that we always say, Bab hi Bhagwan, okay? Sorry? Bab Bhagwan hai. Yes, the reason why we are saying price is God is people in India, especially people from Dalal Street, understands that price is the supreme thing, and whatever indicators that we are plotting in the modern era of technical analysis is just a derivative of it. Unless and until there is a price action, you can't derive other indicators based on that particular stuff. So if you have a very confident understanding or the control of the price and how to plot it in different styles, then you are a winner into this particular stream called technical analysis, right? Now what happened is, like, over a period of time, what happened, HOMA understood that beyond price, there are many things that is working. To his surprise, he understood that there's something beyond the sentiment. What happens is, like, he has even written in one of the two books that we have referred here, he mentioned saying that if everyone is a buyer, then why do the price go down? Right? If he says that the psychology is working at the back of it, and everyone is, say, suppose if famine is there or some natural calamity is there and everyone wants rice and everyone is a buyer, at a point of time, over a period of time, the buyers keep buying but the prices goes down. Why? He wanted to understand that. And he understood that if the price can be plotted in different styles of price charting, you will actually derive at a different themes that is working behind this particular price charting concept. And we have a few of the offshoots of Japanese candlesticks, which is the prime base, which is, we call this as Renko, the Kagi, TLB charting, Heikin Ashi, and point and figure. So these are offshoots of Japanese candlesticks. Most of has been derived from HOMA and his team himself. So what happens is, he just wanted to plot these prices in different styles. That is what he does. And unfortunately, what happens is, like, in today's world, we start an argument saying that Renko is the best, Heikin Ashi is the best, P&F is the best. Some says it's a raw candlesticks that is the best. Aisa kuch bhi nahi hai. Please understand. Our only objective of coming into the market is very clear, that we need to make extra bucks. I'll always tell whoever comes to me that if your intention is saying that I am a passionate guy, I want to learn markets. If I say that I love numbers, I just want to understand the psyche of market, please, you are lying to your own self. When you look at mirror and stand in front of it, I can firmly say at least 99% of all the people who are coming into the market, the only objective is very simple, to make that extra buck. There may be 1% who are hardcore researchers, I don't deny it, but then most of them who are entering into the market are with the intention of making extra money. There's nothing wrong in it. we have a platform wherein we can use our brilliance to make extra money out of it. But one thing you need to understand is it's not that all easy. For that, you need to put your own mehnat. Unfortunately, what happens is like you don't require any qualification to get into this particular system of stock market. That is quite unfortunate. Even anyone who has little capital can enter. A person who has high level of knowledge can enter into this stock market. And people who have huge money but doesn't understand anything about stock market, they are also welcome into this particular space. So what happens is like, since it's quite wide open, there are no restrictions in the qualifications, people are falling a trap into this particular system, even before learning. Unfortunately, after they lose most of their chunk of the capital, they will understand that, yes, now it's time I need to start learning. So start focusing on a different aspect, start thinking about technical analysis on a different level, which I will say that understand technical analysis right from the beginning. You need to, if you know to understand how to read a price chart in given in a different forms, then you can go much advanced and take it to the next level. So this is just forms of charting that we have, Renko and Kagi. Last time we discussed on the Renko part, I have made it very clear last time that Renko, I'm using it for the event and not for day trading or anything else. But I have received so many queries asking, what is the strategy for day trading? Brother, please understand one thing that I've never said that Renko is suitable for trading. I've never said that Renko is the ultimum and that is the only thumb rule that you need to follow. Everything else is ascribed. No. I'm saying that you need to understand the price charting in different forms. Try to understand the different forms in that true nature. And the combination of all the price charting put together will give you a holistic view of what exactly happening in the market. And I'm saying that if you're getting at least 85% consistently of putting all these things to a holistic view, then you are a successful. Never, please never go at the back of getting 100% accuracy in any form of charting or any kind of indicators that we have. You will never get that. Even if you are getting 80-85% always consistent profit, I am saying that you will definitely be a net profit winner into this particular stream. Unfortunately, what happens? Many of us, what happens is like they wanted to catch the top and the bottom. No, it's not that easy. People are there who can catch the tops and bottom, but the kind of effort, the kind of years of experience or research that goes into understanding the price is very huge. It is not that simple, my friends. I will tell you that. There are only two type of people that we have coming into the market. One is who want to understand the forecasting part. The second type of people who are into the stock market is the trend riders. So try to understand the basic things, clear out, understand different forms of price charting. Once you put all these pieces together, you will have a holistic view of what exactly markets want to communicate to you. I always tell that I speak to my charts more than I speak with my wife and kids. That is a fact. My wife is here. She knows and she will say that, yes, this guy always sit with his charts most of the time. I don't know what he is doing. She will say that. But the fact is, you need to understand that I am actually communicating with my charts. Once you are dedicated in reading the charts again and again, over a period of time, the charts actually started speaking to you. That is a fact. The charts will give you a clarity that, yes, now it's time that we are going to go down. Now it's time that we are going to get into consolidation phase. Now it's the right time that we are going to make a move on the upside. So actually, prices actually start speaking to you over a period of time if you are focused on a series of price charting more than indicators. Unfortunately, what happens is Nowadays, what happens, we have n number of indicators, and people claim that this is the best indicator. I have never come across one such indicator which has given me 100% time. I have many friends, see, even sitting in the Wall Street, but I have never come across any indicator that works almost all times. It is not a possibility. Yes, sir. I'll take your question. Yes, I will take. Please give me some time. Let me continue with the flow. So what happens is, like, you need to understand the different price charting patterns and different forms of it. Once you piece or put in all the pieces together, you will understand how exactly the market is functioning at the back of it. So I just want to bring to the notice of the Renko and the Kagi chart. Kagi chart is all about how we read it as the sentimental part. Whenever the sentimental turns yin and yang, it has been plotted in the black and the red lines. So different styles of charting is used for different views. Say, suppose if we speak about the TLB, three-line break charts, it basically gives you an idea whether there is a breakout or breakdown on the particular stock or a script. And when we speak about Heikin Ashi, it is all about understanding the momentum. Unless and until you have a momentum, even after the breakout or breakdown, if you don't have the momentum building into that particular trend, you will have unprofitable trade, right? So these are different forms. You need to understand that Japanese candlesticks takes into consideration all the high point at the low point, the opening as well as the low, but the different offshoots of Japanese candlesticks charting will give you different perspective or the subcategories of the price charting of the Japanese candlesticks. So if you were to look how holistic that we look at it, it's like first we understand whether there's a breakout or a breakdown in a price pattern through using TLB chart. Then we will understand whether the sentiment is changing or not using the Kagi. Then once these two are confirmed, we will wait for the next day to understand from the Heikin Ashi chart whether the momentum is building towards the new trend. Right? So this is how you need to coordinate with different price pattern charts and get a holistic view. And why are we discussing all these things here at this particular platform? The reason is very simple. Over the next 10 years, next one decade, I foresee that the next evolution of technical analysis, the contribution to the technical analysis, will come from India and China. Okay? And I actually see that many experts are sitting out here, right in front of me. If you were to contribute, or if you were to put in your own research time in understanding this price, which is the starting point of understanding technical analysis, I'm quite sure that one thing you need to understand, that your contribution to the evolving field of study called technical analysis is most welcome. And I actually see many people sitting out here will be the contributors to the next phase of technical analysis. If you were to look at it, Homa, who has started his career or who has laid the foundation stone for technical analysis, and he had a set of people coming in from the Japanese. From there, it moved to the Britishers. Okay. The next set of analysis or the contribution to the field of technical analysis came from the Britishers. Then it moved to the West. The most of the indicators that we are popularly working on right now is coming from the West. Now, over the next few decades, I see that the swing from the West will be towards the Asia, and the Indians and the Chinese are the next set of people who are going to contribute. Or what happens is, like, the contribution from India and Indians and the Chinese will be the highest over the next few decades, right? If you want to become a contributor, well, there are a few things that you need to understand. You should become a very good researcher. Even before you become a very good researcher, you should understand in principle, the laying foundation, right from the foundation, what exactly has taken place in this field. It is something like I am seeing you, in a, if you were to give in the medical term, I see you as a different heart surgeon, the brain specialist over a period, over a long period of time, say in next 2 decades or 3 decades. But even if someone wants to become a brain specialist or a heart surgeon, pehle what needs to be done, you have to clear out the MBBS, right? It's a general practitioner that we say. So something of that sort, if we want to really practice into the indicators, if we really want to practice the most focused aspect of different price charting concept, first, you need to understand the basics right from the beginning, understand from where the roots are coming. From there, you take it to the next level. This is my humble piece of advice. Please don't run behind the indicators right then. Even if you don't understand the basics, then there's no point of it. And please, please, it's my humble request, having 13 years of experience into this particular charting industry, humble request is that never, please search for something which is 100%. It is not possible. If you can find out something which is 85, 90% consistent, well, very, very well said, and thumbs up to you. You have found out the perfect strategy for you. For that, you need to have the patience, need to work more and more, right? Now coming to the basic constitution of Heikin Ashi charting. As I said, Heikin Ashi charting is all about understanding the momentum of a particular trend. So what happens here is, this is a time lagging charting that we will say, because this takes into consideration the today's candle as well as the previous candle. It is a combination of today's action as well as yesterday's action. So it automatically becomes a lagging price pattern or price charting. So people are asking, the moment when we announced that we are speaking about Heikin Ashi, they were started asking like, is it more powerful than Renko? Will you get 100% success by following this Heikin Ashi? No, I'm just giving you a different perspective of how the prices can be plot. The prices want to speak to you. Just listen to it. And prices also go wrong. I'm not saying, you have seen whipsaws even in the candlestick. But the best part of Heikin Ashi charting is like, how do I compare? I'll give you a simple example. I'm speaking, and if every one of you in this particular hall starts speaking out, will you be in a position to listen to someone? No. There will be complete noise and chaos in this particular room. That I will identify it as a Japanese candlestick. If I stop speaking and everyone is also not speaking in this particular group, it will be completely silent and it will be like a meditation hall. Can we prolong such a day? Definitely no. That I will call it as a Renko. If I'm speaking and everyone is listening to me and there are no other counter voices that is coming up, I will say that this is a sound which wants to communicate something from this particular area to that of the two sections of this particular hall. That is sound, which I call it as a Heikin Ashi. So if you were to ask, does we require noise? Definitely, yes, we require noise. Do we require silence and meditation? Definitely, that is also required. Different forms of price charting gives different angles of reading the price patterns behind it, what gets into the price. So holistic view is what we need, but understand the different forms of it and try to have a holistic view on the market. And once you have that holistic view, over a period of time, say around 1 year, 2 years, if you consistently put on this holistic view, I'm sure that the prices will actually start speaking to you, rather than you asking us, for that matter, any other expert, where is this particular stock going, where this particular chart is looking like, how good it is and all those stuff. Rather than you asking us, we are also human beings. We also have that error of judgment. But if you dedicate for the next 1 year, 2 year, 3 year down the line, the prices will start speaking to you, and that price chart which is going to speak to you will be 100% correct. Right? So please don't be carried away if I'm speaking about Heikin Ashi, this is the ultimum. No. Please don't be carried away. Because people have understood over the last one period of 1 year time horizon, I've seen that after making that Renko contribution to this particular FinBridge platform, we understood that people have started following different trading strategies on Renko. No. Renko, at any given point of time, it shows you what is the market positioned on a particular day. And we have one basic misconception that wherever the market positioning is, either long or the side, market always goes against us. Please take it. No, it is not so. The reason is very simple. We have, say, suppose if I have created short, all my friends have created short, and the market goes up, we think that market is playing against us. No, it is not the case. The reason is very simple. The smart money has positioned long, and they want to protect their position. And they will do anything to ensure that their position is protected. And that is the case even the last week on the budget day we have seen. The Renko was very clear positive. I have said to see only Renko the day prior to an event. Renko was clear bullish. And it is only because of that particular reason that we had just minus 10 on Nifty. To ensure that the smart money is positioned on the long side as well as they want to protect their position. And I don't know, people have started speaking about SBI buying, LIC buying. No, sorry my friends. You are actually giving lame excuses. You think that people actually want to snatch money from you. It is not so. You have read the charts wrong. It's our own fault. And why we want to put the blame on others, the blame game. Please don't do that. Do your homework. If you're sticking with a particular strategy, stick with that. Please don't skip on from one strategy to the other every time. Don't do it. So what happens is like, since if this is what going to happen, if I give some strategy on Heikin Ashi, I'm sure that over the next one period of 1 year time, everyone will be at the back of that particular Heikin Ashi charting. This is the reason why I want to make it very clear that price charting is all about different forms, and different forms have different understanding, or they want to give different view on a particular market. Once you put all these pieces together, only then you will get a holistic view. If you think that I'm going to give you some magic formula which works 90%, 95% of the time, no. This is not the platform, I'm not going to give that. But I'm making it very clear, if you are dedicated, if you are interested in making this field as your career over a period of time, for the next 10 years, 20 years, there is reward awaiting for each one of us. Rather than you dependent on us, you should depend on the price chart. That is the only thing that I just wanted to communicate. In Japanese, Heikin means average and Ashi means pace, which clearly gives, even the basic name itself gives you that it is all about reading momentum. Say, suppose if I were to look at the Nifty, first there is a breakdown. This is the latest Nifty TLB chart on the left. So if you were to understand that the trend has been broken yesterday, right? So what happens, the first thing that we look at is whether there's a breakdown in the trend. First thing that we look at, and yes, it has given me a thumbs up that the trend has changed down. The second thing that we will look at it is whether the sentimental has turned down. It has still not turned out. Maybe in next few days it will turn down. I'm speaking about the Kangi chart, which is on the right of the screen. If you were to look at it, it has not created in, which is the red line. So the sentiment has not completely turned out, but the Renko, the smart money, has already taken a position on the downside. So if you were to look at that, the overweight of the entire Nifty position would be on the downside. And the last but not the least, we look at it in the piece of it is the momentum. And the momentum comes the moment the sentiment turns down. So these are different factors. If you want to completely analyze your own human body, there are different parts. We have a heart, we have a liver, we have a brain. So these are different parts of it. Never think that because we are speaking on a particular topic, that is the ultimum. No. This gives you different aspects. And these are the aspects. This is the beauty of it. We are speaking about indicators. Most of the entire 2 days is covered with many indicators. But these are the forms that has been created in 1780s by a rice merchant, even before the indicators were alive. How do you think that they were successful? The reason is they started understanding price. They started understanding price in a different viewpoint. And if we can start right from there, that is your starting point of a very beautiful career of technical analysis. Why Renko was famous? Because you just had only two things to look at it, either a bull candle or a bear candle. It was very easy for anyone to understand. That is why it has been so successful. Now we have this year we are introducing one more candle. Probably over a long period of time, we will keep introducing different forms and make it, what you say, like the complex things, make it very precise and try to present it in a very simple manner. So this time we are introducing three types of candles, which is the formation of Heikin Ashi. If you were to go and look at Heikin Ashi candles, you will understand that there are only three types of candles is always present. Unlike that of the Japanese candlesticks, wherein you have n number of formations of the candles, in Heikin Ashi, we just have only three things, which is a bullish candle, down or the bearish candle, and a doji-like. We cannot call it a perfect doji. The reason is very simple. The body of this particular doji-like varies depending on the market condition. So these are the only three type of candles that you can find in a Heikin Ashi, and this makes it relatively easy on observation scale to understand the price patterns being formed using HA candles. So if you were to give a difference of how it is different from the Japanese candlestick or a Renko, as I said, Heikin Ashi has only three patterns, a bullish, bearish, and a doji-like. But in candlesticks, you have 100 plus, which we commonly call as a hammer, many things are there, like the hammer is there, the inverted hammer. So n number of patterns, n number of candles are there in the Japanese candlestick. But if you were to look at it, in Heikin Ashi, there are only three. But when it comes to Renko, we just have only two forms, which is the bullish as well as the bearish candles, nothing else. To understand Heikin Ashi, we just have five simple rules. But in terms of Japanese candlestick, the pattern itself, the formation itself has different meaning and different rules, right? Heikin Ashi is all about easy to understand, but little complicated when it compares to that of a Renko. I'll make it very clear because Renko has just only two type of candles or the bricks. It's very easy to understand. It is like a brick game that we are playing around with the market. That is Renko. But Heikin Ashi has little more depth in it because we are not eliminating any noise, but we are actually capturing each and every noise and try to bring it out what exactly happens with a particular chart. Right? Japanese candlestick is all about visual observation. If you are a very good observer trying to understand what is happening in the Japanese candlestick, then you are very successful reading at the candlestick charts. But the best part of being in Renko, or sorry, Heikin Ashi, is that this can be quantified. Over a period of time, over the last 1 year, when we opened up teaching this Heikin Ashi, we have 100 plus people got trained on the Heikin Ashi charting and how to create strategy. Some of them are here. They will understand that what I'm trying to say, that even before anything like say around the patterns, looking at the patterns, being subjectical and all those things, you can actually quantify what exactly you are looking at on this particular chart.
Time, Praveen sir.
So it is more than visual observation, it can also be quantified looking at the momentum itself in the market. If the momentum is dying, you are for sure that the trend is going to take a reverse, right? So there are some formulas which we have kept it as a secret, which is kept it for people who are interested into getting known on the Heikin Ashi charting and Heikin Ashi patterns. For them, we have kept it aside, but I'm just giving a holistic view on this basic introduction of this Heikin Ashi charting. These are the formulas that you will get it across on how to calculate the HA candle. One thing you need to observe is that, again, in a HA candle, there are only 4 points, open, high, low, and close. But when it comes to Heikin Ashi candle, the prices are derived from today's action as well as the previous day's action. And if you were to understand, on the HA candle, the closing is being calculated first. The reason is very simple. It is the average of the today's action only. The other 3 points, which is the open, the high, and the low points, take into consideration not only today's price, but even the previous day's price action in the market. And that gives you like a combination of the last two candles, or 2 days candle, or 2 weeks candle, put it in together into a single form. That what comprises HA candle all about. There are 5 set of rules, as I said, for Heikin Ashi. A sequence of white bodies identifies an uptrend. A sequence of red bodies identify a downtrend. It is very easy, doesn't require any explanation on it. But one thing I just wanted to tell you that whenever we see a Heikin Ashi candles getting formed, right, with a solid base, it is a continuation and gathering of more and more momentum towards that particular candle. There are only 3 types, I said, a bullish candle, a bearish candle, and a doji like. So if you were to look at the candles, if there is a strong solid base, larger one, that depends on the momentum. The higher the momentum, the prices action will actually drive. People are not feared getting into the momentum. It is always like, see, you might be thinking that I want to try to catch the top and the bottom. For you and me, it is okay as long as we are playing with 1 lot or 2 lots. But the smart money always have huge chunk of position. They can't try to catch the top and the bottom. It is always like the accumulation and distribution that they do. Correct? So what happens is like the more and more the price getting momentum is moving towards the direction of that new trend, people will join in. The smart money will keep on averaging on the profits. What we do, the retail, on the opposite side, we keep averaging on the losses, which is actually riding against the trend. And that is why we lose. But if you understand the trend and keep riding on the trend, keep on averaging on the profits, definitely you will exit in a very handsome amount also. So this is the first rule that we have, very simple rule. A sequence of white bodies identified as a uptrend, a sequence of red bodies identified to be as a downtrend. So if you were to look at this particular chart, yes? Getting it? Okay. So if you were to identify these set of downtrending candles, these are all Heikin Ashi candles, you can understand one thing is that the momentum get stuck here after 5 candles. The momentum gets slowed down. There are 2 options available. One thing is that the momentum can pick up after a certain period of time, or the momentum can completely dissolve and change for the better on the other side. So that is how you start reading different forms of it. So there is no guarantee that it has to change. But whenever you see a formation that is in kind of doji-like, There is no clear momentum on any particular trending side. That is how you need to understand this particular charting pattern. Right? So always a solid candle, a sequence of solid candle will definitely get more profit for you, because that is how we identify whether a particular stock is trending upside or on the other side. Plus the momentum, whether it is keep building in on or actually moving away from this particular stock. Correct? The second set of rules that we have. Uptrend gets stronger with longer white green bodies, and downtrend gets stronger with longer black and red bodies on the lower side. This is what I just briefly spoke about. The more and more the length of the candle getting stronger, it shows that the momentum is actually building up very, very fast. The moment you start seeing the shrinkage of this particular body, even on the upside, I'm telling you that the momentum is actually fading away from that particular stock, and it is time that you also be on the cautious front. As I said, there are two possibilities. The momentum can bring back into this particular stock or take it to the next level. That is where you need to understand, you require to identify from the TLB charts whether there's a continuation of the breakout that we have seen or actually there's a breakdown. So you have different charts for different purposes. All you need to do is like as a puzzle, put it all the things. I understand from different price starting forms what exactly it want to communicate, then build a holistic view on the complete set of stock. That is how we do. Yes. The moment you see first white or the green candle, you can enter, correct? Which is against the red candle. So that is the entry point. But you are not in for sure whether the momentum builds up or not. For that, it requires at least next one or two candles on the same side with higher candle body. Though you understand that, yes, the momentum is actually building it up. Say, if we were to understand, I'm just showing the Nifty. This is Nifty daily chart. The first red candle happened on 31st of Jan. I'm sorry. Okay, the first red candle has happened on 31st of January, which is the day before the budget. Okay? The moment you see a red candle, you can actually take a position on the downside, but you are not in for sure whether the momentum will pick it up towards that particular downside or the momentum will die. How do you understand these two things? If momentum is to die, the next day we have a doji-like. Okay, this puts us into a dilemma whether this trend is going to go down or going to go up. Right? The next day, if you were to look at it, we have received a perfect, very solid momentum driving day or towards the downside. So there's always a challenge on the day one, whenever you see a red candle or a green candle for that matter, you start building it on with that as your stop loss. That is also important, no? You need to know where to exactly keep a stop loss. Either the next day, if there is a perfect bullish candle that is taking place, then you exit, or you keep it that particular high point of that particular day as your stop loss and wait for the momentum to build on. Once you get the momentum, it is just keep on adding more and more position, and you will definitely see on the top, if you were to look at this particular part, this was a clearly bull trending days. The momentum has waned at the top. Even before the trend change is going to take place, the price charting of Heikin Ashi will definitely give you an indication that the momentum has slowed down. What do you mean by momentum has slowed down? It means that the smart money is not in a position to add more position on the long side. That is momentum, yes? Yeah, that is true. I'm not saying, see, what happens is like, I'm not asking you to enter purely based on this particular chart, no? What I'm saying is, there are other forms wherein the TLB chart is there, wherein you get a first entry, and I'm not asking you to catch the top. It is never possible because we are riding the trend. Second thing, once you take a position on this particular, whenever there's a new candle on the opposite side, if you take a candle, there's always a risk involved in it. You keep a stop loss, it definitely is. I'm not asking you to go blindly off this particular Heikin Ashi candles. It is not possible. That is what I'm saying. This chart gives you only momentum, whether the momentum is building on particular stuff or not. You can't take it for granted that this is, the strategy needs to be plotted based on these particular candles. This is not a real picture. The real picture is captured by the Japanese candlesticks. This is an offshoot of Japanese candlestick. But what is required is as a positional trader, right? If you want to average into profits, you need to understand one thing, whether people are adding to my favorable side or not, which we call it as a momentum. Say suppose if these indicators were not there, how do you understand momentum, whether people are actually adding on to your favorable side? This is what he has created. Homa has created in 1780s. Even without indicators, he wants to understand just by looking at the price in a different form. See, if you wait, I'm not giving it on any religious perspective, but don't take it on a counter thing. I'm just giving you. We have different forms of Shakti. Okay? If someone is practicing Hinduism, they will be obviously knowing that we have different forms of Shakti. One is, we call it Saraswati, we call it Durga, we call it Kali. Each form has different avatar for a specific purpose. Similarly, these are all offshoots of the Japanese candlestick created purposefully to understand a different form of looking at it. And if you were to create a strategy and if you were to follow only one specific form of price charting, then you are going for a toss. That is what my view is. You need to have all price charting. You need to see, observe these things in a different perspective. Need to understand whether there is a breakout or breakout. You need to understand whether the sentiment is adding to your favor or not. Then the momentum, whether it is picking it up or not. So these are different ways of putting all the pieces together. I'm just giving you a perspective of looking at or understanding the Heikin Ashi, which is the best, as far as I know, regarding the momentum. Right? Sir, I'm not speaking about any indicator.
Sir, the basic thing is, all are sailing with you, and time is also sailing away.
Yeah. See, the best part is you can add on any indicator in any forms of price charting. But then, I will still say, Bab Bhagwan, if we agree to that, then obviously, yes, the price itself will speak to you first before the indicator does. We keep changing indicators, the parameters also, to give us early entry and early exit. But here, today's purpose is very simple. You see, you can't expect all my 13 years of research to put it down in next 30 minutes. It's not possible. You will not understand. It's not that easy. What I'm saying is like, I understand technical analysis, maybe 1%, 2%, nothing more than that. That much I understand, that's it. I'm still learning. So what happens is, you need to understand one thing for sure, that I'm asking you to start right from the base. Understand the different price starting concept that we have. understand the exact objective of why that particular price setting is being created. Once you understand that, you will know for sure where to look out for. Say, suppose, I'm giving an example. You are saying that the Nifty is going down and down next week, and you want to know whether the momentum is picking up. Now you know for sure which chart to look out. It is the Heikin Ashi chart. Say, suppose if Modi ji is going to give an announcement on Wednesday, and it is a pre-planned event, you know which chart of pricing you need to go and look at it. It will be Renko, because Renko gives you an understanding where the position is being placed. And for sure, the smart money is not going to take a dive against them. Okay? And if the prices are drifting lower, and when you are speaking to your own friends, your trading hall people, and they are speaking that the correction will be over, the markets will move up, you can rely more on the charts, looking at the Kangi charts, where exactly the entire population of the market has a sentiment on, then you can decide. So different price charting has different objective. Try to understand that, then focus on what exactly you want to understand. If your question is whether the momentum is building up, then you have to come here. Of course, yes, I will not say that Japanese candlestick is not important at all. That is the most important, but because it gives you at one go the holistic view. But how many of you, or even I am not a good expert of reading the candlestick chart to a very, very great extent. There are many experts who are sitting out here who can read candlestick charts much better than what I can do. But that is the thing. So if you want to split or decipher this particular candlestick into different forms and try to answer your question, what exactly you're looking out for, then we have an answer in different price charting forms. That is my point of communication in this particular presentation. So these are the five set of rules that we have. A consolidation always reveals that the momentum is dying. There are two possibilities. The momentum can pick up if we are in a very strong trending phase, and the momentum can actually turn against us, wherein the momentum being created on the other side, if we start seeing a series of the red bodies in case of the bullish. So there's always a possibility of a reversal as well as the continuation of the momentum. Here we are actually looking at the momentum, whether it's been built up or not. So beyond HA candles, there lies a beautiful secret of understanding what exactly is happening with the price patterns. This is very, very advanced stage. If you were to give in the medical term, I will say about doing a FRCS or an MD or a heart surgeon, something of that sort. This is very, very deeper. We are not covering out here in this particular seminar. The reason is very simple. We just wanted to give a brief introduction of what exactly Heikin Ashi candles looks like and what exactly we are looking out from an Heikin Ashi candles patterns or charting is all about, looking for the momentum, right? So I'll take it a break. Thank you so much. This is all what I want to communicate. I'm not going to give any strategy. You can play around with the momentum price charting called Heikin Ashi. Thank you, Karan and his team, for giving me an opportunity. Thank you so much.